Hi, Zoe. Okay. All right, so converting converting X and Y into a class. So two component vector. Do we have the start? Okay. So here, rather than having center X and center Y, we just have a single point called center. Hello? Okay. So to change this to a single point, how would you do that? Now that we've made this point class, how do you make a single point? How do you make an instance of this class?
Point dot something or just point parentheses. I'm not sure.
See if you can find how did we make a ball.
Oh, point equals, so it would just be
Cool. Okay, so then where are we here? Let's see. So you wrote point equals point, and this would create a point with an X and a Y, and what would the X part of the point B. So if I said like print point dot x, what would this print out?
Currently it would be 0.
Yeah. Okay, but what if we wanted it to be 300?
You put it in the parens.
Yeah. So here, if we want to change these two things into a single variable called center with 300 comma 300 as the two parts of the point, how would we do that? Or
What do you just add up just
yeah,
point in there?
go ahead and write out what you're thinking.
Just point.
So point, and then what else would you write? And maybe let's call it, we can call it center, just like we call it right now center X and center Y. We can call it center, like the variable could be called center. So here we made a variable point with a lowercase p. We could just as well have done this. So here we have a point called point and another point called center. So here, let's make a point called center. And then in order for it to be part of the point class, we want it to have the name of the class. Yeah, capital P point. And we want it to have, by default, 300, 300. So not point dot center. This is the variable that we're creating. We want just like this. We want to say center equals point 300, 300. So just like here, the way to create a point with the values 300, 300 is to have the name of the class, then parentheses, then 300, 300. So we'll do the same thing here, and then we don't need these two. We can get rid of them.
So that was just me being confused. So this is useless right here.
Yes.
Okay. I thought we were going to use that.
No, this was just for demonstration purposes. Okay, cool. So then, that is the center. But now we need to go update everywhere that we used the variable center. Center underscore x. And we need to change it. So here, we have center x and center y. How would you change this part up? If we now, instead of having two variables, center x and center y, we have just one variable named center. So we're going to have a self.center, and we're going to set it equal to the argument to init called center, just like before we had a self.center x, and we set it to the argument named center x. Self.center x equals center x. We want to change that.
So do we get rid of the x and y component of the variables for now?
Go ahead and write out what you mean.
I mean, this is just a name, right? So it could. So then, would it? So what I'm asking is, for now, do we want x and y to be just in one variable, or do we want x and y to be separate?
We are combining the x and y into, instead of having two separate variables, center underscore x and center underscore y, okay, we're going to have one variable, center. So we're going to have one line. Yeah, self.center equals center. And then we can get rid of these lines. And let's go update here. everywhere that center underscore x or center underscore y shows up, although I think it's always going to be center underscore y because we don't change the x value. So we want center dot y. Yeah. This one we can leave alone for now. And we should probably do the same thing for velocity. So center underscore y, change that to a dot. Okay. So now let's change we don't use ball center y anymore. I still have these two variables, but I don't actually use them anywhere. Do you have them? Did you already get rid of them?
I still have ball center x somehow.
Alright, I'm gonna get rid of them because now the fact that we start at 300, 300 is stored right here. So, okay. So then, what about ball velocity y? Yeah, that also I don't use. So I'm just going to get rid of it. Ball velocity y, yeah. Is there any other unused variables here? Pivot point. Yeah, I don't use that. Arm length. Height. Looks like I don't use that either. This was all for the pendulum, and I guess I never got rid of it. Ball radius, I think I don't actually use that anywhere else. Okay, so now that we have gotten rid of some extraneous variables, that was kind of unrelated to the change of making center instead of center x and center y. But yeah, okay, so now that I've done that, let's go activate this and try, whoa, let's try, oh yeah, I got my taxes to the point where it it automatically fills out the PDF for me. So it'll ask me, like, what's your name? And then it'll put that into the PDF for me, which is cool.
Nice.
Yeah. Okay, and then how do I run this? Oh, I just need to evaluate the whole buffer. Okay, so oh, no. I wonder what live pi mode is. Let's see. Refactor. How do I start or switch to REPL? Live pi mode. Execute? Execute file. Save. Uh-oh. Inv- invalid syntax. Perhaps you forgot a comma. I sure did. Looks like yours is running, so you did not forget that comma. Alrighty. Okay. Center Y is not defined. I thought I got rid of all of them. Center Y. Oh, cool. All right, let's try that one more time. Still. Oh, there was a center.x. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, so that's the, so what you just got is what I have right now. The error.
Tuple has no attribute y. Huh. Tuple has no attribute y. Self.center. Do we ever did we already had a variable called self.center? I see. So we actually can get rid of that. And then here where we draw, I guess we can do this. So we were updating the variable self.center up here to be a tuple. But we didn't need to do that. We could also here, instead of doing like making this tuple right here, we could up here in the point class do def tuple self return self.x self.y, and then down here we could do self.center.tuple. It's still too long. Do you like one of those better?
I think this looks cleaner.
Yeah, we're probably going to want to be able to do this same thing with other stuff. I hope tuple. Oh, tuple is the name of a type. This might not work. It might be that the fact that it's a keyword means that it can't also be the name of a field
or a method. Make it tuply.
To play. I don't know. Let's find out.
People understand what that means.
Hopefully. It looks like it can be used. Mine is running, and it's fine.
Bad syntax. What?
Oh. You need an extra close parenthesis at the end of line 117. Oh, actually, no. You need, to not have the open parenthesis.
What? Tuple object has no tuply. Hello?
So right here, call it tuple instead of tuply.
Oh. But I named it tuply here.
Tuple works. I tried it out.
No.
You need to also get rid of line 112.
Oh.
The line that turned center into a tuple.
Also, that's a problem that the ball bounces above where it started. We should probably fix that.
Well, maybe it starts with some downward velocity. Is the downward velocity non-zero?
Oh, yeah. I think it starts at 200. Okay.
We could change that if you want. We could start it off at zero. I think we changed it initially because it looked like it was too slow.
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, Y velocity 200. So, do you want to change that or nah?
I think for now it's fine. I think we can focus on the class first.
Okay. Whoops. Okay, so we converted the center. We should convert the velocity as well. So point makes sense for center, but it doesn't really make sense for velocity, the name point. But the idea of having an X component and a Y component is still, like, that part still makes sense. Or at least to me. Do you want to keep calling it point, even though...
We call it components, I think. Does that work?
It does have two components inside of it. I was thinking like Vector2d.
I mean, yeah, that works.
Oh, right, Vector2d. Duh. Okay. So now velocity, we can do the same thing. And we had x velocity and y velocity. 200? And now velocity underscore y, we should set to just velocity. And velocity underscore y here, we can set it to 0. Cool. Is that it? Yes. Okay. Let's see if it still runs. All right, mine seems to be working. Cool. Okay. And now we should probably have an acceleration as well. But I think we're pretty well done converting the X and Y code into a class, then do a cannonball fired directly sideways. So let's make a commit. Oh shoot, I don't have this going. Cool.
Oh. Okay. I didn't even do the diff. I didn't make a commit here either.
Oh, whoops. I thought we had. But oh well.
It's fine.
Okay. So now we have velocity as a Vector2d. If we wanted to fire it directly sideways, how would we need to change? Or actually, do you want to do that? That's what I have here.
Yeah.
Okay. So how should we update this code? What's something that you can think of that we could do to make it so that the ball goes sideways? I'm thinking we could make like successive approximations, just like we've done with the ball drop. We wrote code and then we realized, oh, balls don't actually bounce forever, and oh, it looks like it's going through the floor. So we could do something similar with the ball going sideways, the cannon fire. We can like write some code and then go, oh, that's not quite right, and then write some more code and so on.
Yeah. Okay. Think the first thing. Well, actually, I don't know what the first thing would be. Also, we don't need this either. Probably not even this either. I don't think we use gravity.
I do. I have it down here.
Oh, we do. Okay. Well, mass.
Okay. Doesn't look like it.
Okay. So now, okay, so then,
maybe let's have it start over on the left-hand side of the screen. So the center, to begin with, can be on the left-hand side. What would this number change to?
I think 20 because of the radius.
Yeah, I wonder if you can just put radius here and then put it here. I don't think so, but I'm curious to see what happens when I try this. Nope, it didn't like that. Okay. Darn. Well, I guess we could put it to zero there, and then here, down here, here, do self dot center dot x equals self dot radius, which is down here, there. Did that work? Yes, that did. Now, it looks like it's rolling on the left edge of the screen. Okay. Cool. Nice. Okay, so then if we wanted it to be moving to the right, how would we update this?
We would have velocity not equal 0 for now. So we'll say...
Let's make it a small number.
5.
Sure. Okay. And then if the velocity in the x direction is 25, how do we make it so that it actually goes to the right when it gets drawn? How do we make it so that it's drawn more to the right?
I am looking. I don't... Wait. I actually don't know how we did that or how we did it for the y.
Okay, so let's go look at how did we... Where does velocity dot y show up? So self dot velocity dot y. So this is just checking whether the ball is still. Although, we're probably going to have to update this, because this is just checking whether it is still in the y direction. Maybe that's what we want, though, because this is checking whether it should keep bouncing. And I guess.
Oh, okay. I see here.
Do it here. Yeah, we can come back to that. So this is for. Wait, where are you? Oh, you're in update position. Okay, so update position, self.center.x plus equals...
Let's do the same thing as self and not, I guess. But let's just do self.velocityx, and then we'll just see how it works.
We want to update it only for the amount of time since the last frame. So we do need this part.
Okay.
This part means, so this part makes it a different amount based on whether the last frame was a tenth of a second ago or 10 seconds ago. That would be a very different amount of travel that it would do. Hey, that looks pretty good. Let me try it on mine.
So we just created a sine, basically.
What?
We just created a sine wave. Cosine.
Like a...
Cosine at the top.
Yeah, cosine because it starts at the top. But also, it is... Each peak is a little bit lower than the last peak, so... There's that. It's not quite the sine wave.
Okay, well, now it is gone. Okay, nice.
So mine went off the screen, so I can't really tell, where it is.
Gonna move. Gonna do it. One.
The velocity 1 instead of 25.
Yeah. Just to see if we can see it stop bouncing.
Oh yeah. It's moving so slow. But it is moving.
That's so slow. Okay. But other than that, I think it's working.
Cool. I'm going to let mine continue running, see if see what it looks like. I also, now that I watched it go off the edge, I kind of want to make it bounce off the left and right edges too, and not just off of the floor.
Okay.
So let's, I'm gonna go add that as a to-do. It looks like it kind of looked like it was floating above the ground, but now
also the X is still going, so you can see it like inch forward.
Yeah. Which that's somewhat realistic, but after a little while of rolling, it would stop in real life. So stop rolling after stop bouncing. So yeah. But I think we made it fire directly sideways. That part works.
Yeah.
I'm stopped. I didn't notice yours say that before.
Oh yeah. Well, now it's kind of false. It's not stop, but
yeah. Okay. Then what do you want to do? Oops.
Okay. Let's
there we go. All right. So we did that. Excuse me. We ignore wind resistance. The X velocity stays constant. So we did that. The Y velocity changes with gravity still. And then I guess that's all there was for this to do. And now we have this bouncing off of the left and right edges.
Okay, so then
or rolling or squish.
Okay. I also think a task right now is maybe like change all of these ones to update velocity Y. And then like should bounce like up or
okay.
Down. So like we actually have, so because everything's gonna be in this class, right? Everything else that we
to
will be adding.
Update velocity should also do X. Rather than having this method be named update velocity Y, I think we should just have it be update velocity, but have it update the X and the Y.
Okay.
And then same with like this method. Yeah, so we need the helper methods. Update should also do X velocity. To do update other helpers as well, to do X velocity, e.g. is still. All right, okay, so Oh, I just realized a better way of doing this would be to set it to none, and then here we could say if self.center.x, or not self.center, yes, if not self.center.x, then do that. None is a value that means there is no value. And so here we can check that is none. It's another way we could do it. Then we want to set it to a default value. Not super important. All right, lower edge. That really does only deal with the y value. But actually, that makes me think of, we could have a left edge and a right edge.
And I was thinking maybe it could look kind of, in the end it would be just like a bouncy ball in a box, so we could also do an upper edge as well.
Sure. Do you want to make those right now?
Yeah, sure. Then center x. So then instead of plus, wait, we would minus. No, it would plus. It would still plus.
So this is finding the upper edge of the ball, which is going to be center in y minus the radius.
Minus what?
Because the y axis is flipped. And then the left edge of the ball would be the center x. I think you already did that. Cool. And the right edge would be this number plus this number. Cool.
Wait, what?
The right edge would be the center plus the radius. And the left edge would be the center. Oh, you have upper edge equals self.center.x minus self.radius. Your line 58.
This should be y.
You called this method upper edge.
Okay.
Oh, I guess I did kind of do mine in a weird order. Here, let me rearrange. Alright, so upper edge, lower edge. These two, then left edge, right edge.
Okay, so like that.
Yeah, so it should be upper and lower deal with the y value, left and right deal with the x value, and then upper is minus because x y axis is flipped, lower is plus because y axis is flipped. Left is minus, right is plus. Oh yeah, this whole prior center y. So we're probably gonna need like a self dot prior center. I just looked at my Pygame window, and the ball just went off the edge of the screen.
Oh, yeah, it's gone.
So this prior center, we're going to have to update it when self.center gets updated, does self.center get updated? I guess here it's getting updated. And here it's getting updated. So what we, if we want the prior center, how did we use prior center? Prior center Y. So how does prior center Y get used here in prior lower edge? And that's it. Okay, how does prior lower edge get used? Ah, whether or not it should bounce. So whether or not it just went, it hit the floor. So this should bounce. Really what we're going to need is something like, did it just hit the floor? And a different thing for, did it just hit the left wall? And did it just hit the right wall? So, to do, make method for left, detecting, hitting all of the walls. And so update velocity should also do x velocity. So we're like in the middle of prior center. Make a prior center, and in support of that, we need to make methods for detecting hitting each of the walls, e.g. floor, hit left wall, etc., and use those method called should bounce should be hit floor instead, I think. Does that seem right?
Yeah, I think so.
So, it used to be that this, the only reason to bounce was hitting the floor, so this name made sense, but yeah, now that we have other ways of bouncing, this method is not as good, I don't think.
Yeah.
And all of that is, if we're use it instead of prior center Y, start here next time. Do you want to see how far we can get in the next minute?
Sure.
Or just cut it short there. Prior center. So we can make a prior center and then prior center. And everywhere that we have prior center dot or underscore y, we can change it to prior center dot y. Except, yeah, I guess we could leave that. Oh, is that it? Okay, and then prior lower edge. Let's see. So this should be hit floor. So I don't know what to do in Python, but in like Lisp, I would call this hit floor question mark because this is determining whether we hit the floor. If we just call it hit floor, that kind of sounds like we're
Telling it to hit the floor.
yeah.
Deploy Q.
Yeah, actually, sometimes I've seen underscore p for predicate. Like this is a predicate, this is a question. Similar idea, Q. We could use Q. Yeah. And then what was it called before? Should bounce. Okay, so should bounce is now hit floor Q, and that's probably the only place it was used. Yes, okay, cool. And then this bounce right here, we're gonna need to update that as well. So I'll just make another to-do so that we can end somewhere. Change bounce to, I don't know, bounce off floor or hit floor. So need to have other methods for bouncing off walls and ceiling too. Okay, I don't know. Do you like this name for? I did just when I said it out loud, I said bounce off floor. Because the
No.
exact code will be different whether it's bouncing off of the floor or the walls or the
Yeah,
ceiling.
we can also, yeah, bounce off floor bounce, either work, I think.
Floor bounce. I like that. And we can call it there. That's good. See you next time. Bye.
Sounds good. Thank you. But